One of the biggest challenges about building a 74-foot steel sailboat in the middle of Oklahoma is there's no opportunity to lay our hands on parts that are working on a boat and to see what different boats use. And so touching something is really important to me, and the best place to do that is a marine consignment store. There isn't one here. If you wanted bass boat parts, yeah, we might have that, but nothing like big sailboats. So we went to New England to look at boats, and one of the places we stopped was a Marine Consignment of Wickford. It was open on a Monday. Most of these places are closed on Monday, but this one happened to be open, and let me show you around that store. I saw one of these winches in the Hirschhoff Museum. Folding props. Cutlass bearings. Transmissions. Exhaust manifold. We have to get something like that for the Cummins would be nice. Or make it. I think we can just build one. Oh shoot, we ought to put that on the list. Water pumps. Oh, the heads. It's your simple bucket head. Kind of looks like a regular toilet, doesn't it? It's porcelain. This one's nice.
Self-contained.
Yeah. You think we can get that on the airplane? That's not bad, actually. $450 for a... the toilet with all the workers.
Less than 50 pounds.
Let's see. I don't know what it... Oh, it's got a macerator pump all inside of it. I'll make sure you get parts for it or rebuild them. High profile 12 volt self-contained. See, they all have some sort of a pump apparatus attached to the bottom of them. And those are the parts that fail. I kind of like this brass pump stuck in here. Yeah, something like that we could fix. It's just gonna be a matter of seals and such. Well, that's flimsy. I'm not crazy about the all plastic ones. See, I'm afraid that something in that would give a problem. Yeah, it's just too cheap. No. It's just going to get more brittle as it gets older and cold. Oh, I haven't seen a bow thruster yet. Dagger boards? Heaters? Oh, a stove? Ovens? 350 bucks for an oven. Oh, that's been around the corner. And self-steering gear. Police. Well, that sure looks like Dillerin. $50. $25. Well, there's a lot of ball bearings in there. Probably roller bearings, I guess. Bilge pumps on this side. I like to think we could make something with a tire. This has got two chambers on it and a handle in between that works both chambers. It just didn't look that tough to build. What do they cost? $250. Here's a cool one. It's engine driven, and it's got a big impeller pump there, and there's a spare impeller for it, and it has a clutch that you can lock in and out on it. How nice. And that was that. $300. Zinks. Look at that. It was like somebody cast that at home nearly. Boarding ladders, fenders, all your shore power. Like little electrical doodads down this aisle. $45 for that turnbuckle. And you can buy a galvanized one for less than half that. $50 a piece for that cleat. $100 for a 24-volt blower. That's the kind of bilge pump I'm thinking we could build. Big diaphragm on the top. $450 for it. There's its mate. Yeah, we could build that. It's nothing but a pot, a ring to hold down the diaphragm and a push plate on it. Getting the diaphragm might be the toughest part. Maybe just big sheet, flat sheet. Yeah, has to be formed somehow, maybe. Maybe not. Yeah, this is throttle and control land. Jeez, finding the one that fit your engine, that'd be the trick. Trailer stuff. Paper charts. Lighting. You know, I think this is the way to get radars. Just, find somebody putting in the newest and latest equipment on their boat and ask them what they'll sell the old one laying on the dock for. This one here is $600. You know, sitting on the dock with somebody that just put on their brand new one. I bet it would be a couple hundred. Get the advantage of knowing who you're buying it from and what condition it's in. Oh, PDF land. Jeez. Swim ladders. Fenders. Ooh. Ooh, what is that? Oh, it's a winch. There's, look at that, it's a little bitty bat roller, isn't that cute? Oh, there's another one up there, anchor winch. But this one, $250. It's electric, but it's a captive spool, meaning that you can't pull it off the end. But it's electric, and they got a lot of them, and they're only $250 a piece. Oh, they got four of them here. Wow, I do like how compact they are. Various sizes. That's a thought. It's plated, it's not brass or bronze, it's plated with something. And that they got a gearbox between the motor and the spool. See, my problem with a captive spool like that is I can't just take tension on the line, unwrap it from that spool and put it onto another one. It's actually trapped onto there. So I don't have a good way of moving this line to a different winch. But I'm thinking we just have a spare winch and there's a connector in the line, the sheet going out. Maybe that's the way to do it. Sometimes that connector's not available. Something like this with a drive shaft and a capstan on it. If the line was on there and spooled up, a different type of spool, then you could still unwrap it, use it somewhere else. Dacron. Let's see, 1¼. Approximately 50 feet for $50. That's not too bad. I have no idea. Maybe a mat? No. Oh, it's core. This is balsa core. You put it in between layers of fiberglass on those plastic boats. It's a cheap ingrain batta core. $250. Shoot, really? Kind of in scuba department too. Battery. The power supply. Oh yeah, for a light. Two is you can take a AGM battery down with you and just spray the contacts with some rubber cement. Works fine too.
Gives you a jet pump.
Probably a Berkeley.
A couple of kayaks. Some sailboats. Oh, pilot house. Somebody did a nice job making my wells look better. Yeah, that's where sailboats come to die, I'm afraid. It's the rubber dinghy graveyard.
Well, I'm kind of glad that this isn't in Oklahoma, because it'd be tempting. Oh, look at that pump.
My God. Now that's a pump.
Okay.
What is this thing, like 6-inch? 36 horsepower?
30 kilowatts.
Yeah, well. We could fire up the generator and run it. Use it for a... Oh, what could we use that for? A bow thruster.